Welcome to Cinemeric Live, application technology made easy, where we present Cinemeric-related topics in simple terms. Our video series is practice-oriented and will take up just a few minutes of your time. Today's topic is peripheral surface transformation with Cinemeric. Here's the agenda. First, there's some general information about peripheral surface transformation. Then we'll deal with basic types of peripheral surface transformation, followed by CNC programming with Cinemeric, on the turning machine, and then on the milling machine. And we'll finish up with a practical session. Cylinder surface transformation, also called TRASSIL, from transformation cylinder, involves drilling and milling operations on the peripheral surface of a cylindrical body in the form of a cylinder surface unwinding process. TRASSIL is programmed in the Cartesian workpiece coordinate system, which means that the programming for pockets, slots, and also drill holes is planar in the conventional way in one plane, with the control then applying the projection on the cylinder surface. So, this is our cylinder, and this is to become our future pocket. With planar programming, then, as mentioned before, the projection of this previously unwound slot or pocket is implemented on the cylinder surface diameter. A good example for TRASSIL machining is the manufacture of recorders. Here are the holes for the pitch. Using the TRASSIL method, these are drilled on the peripheral surface and the surfaces are also milled, which is necessary to obtain the recorder contour. TRASSIL is a turning function and therefore originates from turning technology. TRASSIL can be used on both turning and milling machines. For turning machines, the following applies. Any turning machine with driven tools is suitable for peripheral surface transformation. For milling machines, with the three-axis milling machine and a dividing unit installed, this usually then becomes an A-axis, TRASSIL peripheral surface machining is also possible without any restrictions, with and without slot side offset. More on this later. The following applies for five-axis machines. Machines with rotary swivel tables or mixed head table kinematics are also generally suitable for peripheral surface transformation. And by pulling along the work offset, work is process safe at all times because the distance between the tool tip and the workpiece always remains the same, even when swiveling. Now, for five-axis machines, consider the following. These usually have a rotary table, and it's mandatory to clamp the workpiece in the center of the rotary table. This means that the workholder holding the workpiece must be 100% in the center of the machine table. These workholders usually have a centering pin or other form of workholder centering functions which ensure this 100% centricity. There are two types of TRASSIL machining: TRASSIL machining without slot side compensation and TRASSIL machining with slot side compensation. When machining without slot side offset, we get pockets and slots with curved bottoms, and the walls are oblique to each other. That is, not parallel, but oblique. That's TRASSIL without slot side offset. Using TRASSIL machining with slot side offset, we obtain pockets or slots with even bottoms and parallel walls. That's the difference between machining with slot side offset and without slot side offset. When programming a slot with parallel walls, it should be noted that programming takes place in both directions, both back and forth. Simply in and then out again is not enough. Instead, the contour must always be described back and forth. By programming the center line of the slot to be created back and forth, and with the help of the cutter radius correction G41 or G42, that is, to the left or right of the contour, we're able to produce slots that are wider than the cutter itself or the cutter actually used. The off-end command describes half the slot width, and the control system takes the real physical value of the cutter available for machining from the offset of the tool management. Now the control system has all the components required to calculate the slot fully automatically. Drill machining with the Trasil function allows unrestricted use of the drilling technologies available to us in Synameric Operate. It's irrelevant whether we're dealing with deep hole drilling, tapping, reaming, centering, or just standard drilling with and without stock removal. All functions can be used without restrictions. But when milling with the Trasil function, we always end up with a distorted contour. Here, it's crucial where the so-called reference diameter is defined. As you can see on the left, we get an exact circular contour in the unwinding process on top of the outer diameter of the cylinder, but a distortion at the bottom of the pocket. If the exact circle contour is to be at the bottom of the pocket, as on the right, we then have the distortion on top on the outer diameter of the pocket, but there will be a distortion in any case. It's extremely important to define where the distortion shouldn't be, and that's where the reference diameter must then be located. Almost all of the milling cycles in Trasil can be used without restrictions. However, due to the mentioned distortions in the milling pockets, their practical application is limited, such as for thread milling. A typical application example for Trasil without slot side offset are rollers for the production of blister packs. In our practical session, we'll be demonstrating the production of four workpieces, two on the turning machine and two on the milling machine. Let's take this first example of a cylindrical part. In this case, three slots are typically machined in the peripheral surface in the turning milling process. With Trasil, the machining includes three slots, each offset by 120 degrees from each other, and corresponding holes on the peripheral surface. In the program, the whole thing looks like this. After face turning and turning the contour lengthwise, the contour for the slots is described just like a typical normal slot programmed in the plane. This is then projected, that is, transformed, onto the cylinder with the subsequent path milling cycle. In this path milling cycle, the Trasil function, that is, the peripheral machining surface with C-axis, can be selected. And not only that, you can also select four different variants of machining here, starting with the aforementioned peripheral surface machining C-axis, but also peripheral surface machining with the Y-axis, and both, of course, on the face side as well. This means that one cycle contains four different machining variants. After the first slot has been machined, the C-axis rotation command rotates the part a further 120 degrees to the position of the second slot. Machining is performed in the same way. And then there's the third slot. Again, rotate 120 degrees to complete the contour. The same again for drilling, of course. And here too, you can select the drilling technology to include drilling on the peripheral surface with the C-axis or with the Y-axis, or, as already mentioned, it's possible to machine on the face side. The second example shows the machining of a spiral groove on the peripheral surface, that is, a cylindrical diameter. Although this can be more or less compared to a thread, it's a completely different principle. After all, the spiral groove must be unwound, that is, programmed in length, in order to tell the controller to put it on the outside diameter. This is done after the familiar face and longitudinal turning with a slot milling cycle. Before that, however, some calculations are necessary to achieve the said describing of the slot. We are working with R parameters here, meaning a certain alphanumeric value is written into the so-called offset into the memory. In this case, R1, which is then the angle of the pitch. And R2 is defined in this case for the calculation of the slot unwinding. The result, which is calculated here, is placed for now in the memory for R1 and R2. Now, the special thing about this is that in the slot milling cycle, no alphanumeric characters are entered, and no results or values are calculated. Instead, the said R1 and R2 results are retrieved. Let's take a look, all live, at the manufacturing and machining of this spiral groove. As we know, the Tracil function stems from turning technology. We'll show how to use this function on the milling machine as well, but we need at least one rotary axis on the milling machine. Our example is based on a 5-axis milling machine. This simple example is intended to illustrate how two opposing slots are machined on the peripheral surface. First, the part is vertically clamped into the milling machine, and then the part tilts into the horizontal position so that the cutter can mill the slot. The part then rotates 180 degrees around its own axis, around the center point, and the second slot is machined. The program for this is written in the program guide. The first part is for the first slot, followed by the middle sequence with cycle 800 in the swivel cycle and the command ATRANS C180. This means the part rotates 180 degrees so that the second slot can be machined as already mentioned. The Tracil functionality thus works on the milling machine in the same way as on the turning machine. On the turning machine, we looked at the machining of a spiral groove on a cylindrical part. And now we're machining a spiral groove on a conical part using the milling machine. Here too, the part is clamped vertically in the milling machine. And again, the machine swivels the part to the horizontal position so that the cutter can then mill the spiral groove and follow the angle or pitch of the cone. Machining a spiral groove on a cone is much more complex, also mathematically much more demanding than for a cylindrical part. The program is written in high-level language, for example, and is also known as a parameter program. It's not in ShopMill, not in the program guide, and very importantly, it's not an output from a CAD/CAM system. With Cinemeric Operate workshop-oriented programming, it's very easy to program conventional machining operations. Cinemeric Operate optimally supports program creation with practice-oriented dialogues. And for standard machining operations, programmers can rely on proven technologies or coordinate conversion. The existing machine park of milling and turning machines can be used flexibly. This means that the peripheral surface machining, so typical for turning technology, can also be used on a milling machine. And although workpieces that require peripheral surface machining are usually complex, simple programming allows these parts to be machined efficiently. That's it from us on the subject of peripheral surface machining with Cinemeric. Thank you for watching and see you next time.
Siemens. Ingenuity for life.